This 10-minute video clip you're about to see is only make-believe. But in the real world, yes, it could be happening right this moment. Our story takes place in a little small rural town in southeastern part of Kentucky. The story is about a hothead, know-it-all, 35-year-old kid who's down on his luck and nothing to look forward for. If only he had listened to Mom and Dad. And, as you will see, most likely he wouldn't be in the mess that he's in. So the journey he is about to take puts him behind bars for 20 years. But little does he know, his life is about to be changed forever and ever.
Alright, Josh, you're 35 years old. This is enough. You gotta go get a life of your own. And if you're gonna live another air route, you're gonna go by air route. And that's the way it's gotta be. You are gonna abide by air route.
That's fine. Let me tell you two something.
I'm 35 years old, and I'm no kid. And I got other places I can go and stay. I'm out of here, you can have it. So, as he storms out into the big world, Mom and Dad is saying a prayer for him and hoping that he will get his life together and do right.
Sugar Bridges, get the money out of there. Let's go. Come on. Let's get that money out of there. Come on, give me the cash, please. Go, I ain't got all day. Get that stuff in there. Come on. Go. Get in there.
So, just when he thought he was in the clear of auto theft, a deadly concealed weapon, and armed robbery, he is in hot pursuit of the police across two counties.
You got the wrong man. I didn't hold up no grocery store. Trust me, you got the wrong man.
Yeah, I hear you. That's off the yard, son.
Go ahead.
20 years in the state pen, and you will serve every minute of it.
Josh, looks like you're going to be a long time, boy. You don't want to sit down.
Yeah, that's what you think. Get out of here. Get out of here.
Go ahead and sit down.
Get out of here. Come back here.
After 20 years in the big house, Mr. Muncho Boy has had a lot of time to think things over and realize what he had done. So after Pastor Van Winkle's visit, he's beginning to see a whole new light.
Josh, you know you've done some pretty bad things. But God forgive you all of your sins, and he will help you through this if you believe in him, and he will take care of you and take care of all your sins.
I'm looking at this book today. Have you
looked in this book to believe in God?
Well,
this verse here is to make you better and forget and receive sins of what you've done and help you through this.
Well, I need to change my life. I know I've done that.
Josh, if you read this, it's God's word and it'll be true.
If I could only go back, I'd do everything differently than what I did, you know. Tell you one thing, after this right here, I'm definitely going to be a changed man. There's no doubt about that.
Yes, indeed, he is a changed man. So I guess it just goes to show you, there are some good in the bad and the ugly. Since then, he's given his heart to the Lord, and now it's time to go home to see Mom and Dad.
Well, looks like Josh, you're going home today.
All right, man, I appreciate it. I can't wait to get home and see Mom and Dad. I'm going to make up a lot of bad years and bad moments I put them through. Thanks to you all for everything you've done for me.
Thank God I'm free. Take care, Josh, and keep your nose clean, and God bless you, man. In the past 20 years behind bars, he wouldn't have anything to do with his mom and dad, no visitations or anything like that. He made things right with God. Now it's time to go home and make things right with Mom and Dad. No one home. The house is deserted.
Hey, Leroy.
Yeah.
Hey, man, where's everybody at? Where's Mom, Dad, and all the gang at? Where's everybody at?
Sorry to be the one to tell you this, buddy, but everybody passed away. They're buried right over here in the cemetery.
Oh, no, man, no.
Yeah.
Oh, God, what have I done? Please forgive me, Lord, dude. I'm sorry, Leroy. Then moments later, after about a quarter of a mile walk high up on that mountain, a moment of silence. Please forgive me, Mom and Dad, for all I put you through. I know you're with God in heaven. So after a few hours, after getting over the shock, he makes his way back to the old home place, and what he finds is well worth waiting for. There's something special about this old house. Although everything is gone, but there's so many special memories are here. Oh, but wait, what's this? Looks like an old photograph. Well, what do you know? It's a photograph of Mom and Dad and all the family. Now, look at this. It's the old family Bible. But I'm just a little bit confused. Why was this old photograph of Mom and Dad and all the kids and this old family Bible left behind? You know, I get the strangest feeling that somebody is trying to tell me something. You know, I remember something Pastor Van Winkle said to me, and it still sticks within my mind. Walk in the light as he is in the light, and do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. So, there you have it. Bad boy turns good. And I guess it just goes to show you, there is light on the other end of the tunnel. And now the music video to God Keeps the Wildflowers Blooming on Mom and Dad's Grave.
Where mom and daddy rest beneath the cocoa clay. Though the tears may fill my eyes, there's a smile upon my face. I see God remembers mom and dad. He put flowers on their graves. And there's wildflowers blooming on mom and daddy's grave. There's no tame ones ever brought here. Just as though it was only yesterday, all the hell that my mom and dad went through to live on from day to day. But the love that they both gave us, oh, it was surely heaven sent. And all the heartaches I know I've caused them, God knows I'll always regret.